So in addition to different gas laws like Boyle's law, Charles law, Charles 1, Charles 2, okay, and ideal gas equations, no doubt all gas obeys this one. Actually, all gas obeys these laws at high temperature and low pressure, because every gas behaves like an ideal gas at a high temperature and low pressure. Okay, that's why here at high temperature and low pressure, the gases obeys all these gas laws. Okay. So here, in addition to these gas laws, suppose if the gas obeys an additional law. Additional law means different law. If the pressure varies volume in different way. Okay, suppose we are given the pressure varies with volume according to the equation PV to prop gamma is equal to constant. PV to prop gamma is equal to constant. Sorry, PV square. Already we know this relation. PV square. We are given like this. PV square is equal to constant. It is one additional law. We doesn't know whatever the type of the law, we don't know. So here, suppose the gas obeys an additional law, PV square is equal to constant. Okay. Then, when at a temperature T1, at a temperature T1, of course, at a temperature T1, pressure is P1. Pressure is at a temperature T1, pressure is P1. Okay, at a temperature T2, what is the pressure? They ask it. Like this, they ask it. So here, but we are having additional of PV square is equal to constant. So we are having relation between P and V only. Relation between P and V only. But we have obtained the relation between P and T so that we can have this P2 value. Okay. So in any case, the every gas obeys the ideal gas equation. PV is equal to nRT. So for the given mass of gas, PV is equal to nRT. Every gas obeys this law. So here, for the any gas, nR is constant for the given gas. For the given gas, number of moles that remains constant for the given gas, R is constant. Okay, therefore we can write PV is proportional to capital T no, as it is constant. Here we need the relation between P and T. V should not be there. From this, we can write V is proportional to T by P. We can write no. V is proportional to T by P. Now we substitute this value here. Therefore, from PV square is equal to constant P into V means as V is proportional to T by P, we can write T by P whole square. That is equal to constant. Another constant, of course, the constant may be different. Okay. So then from this formula, we have T square by P is equal to constant now. Because P into T square by P square cancels, so T square by P is equal to constant. Therefore, here, T square by P is constant means P is proportional to T square, we can write now. Or P1 by P2 is equal to, we can write T1 by T2 whole square. In this way, when we are given temperatures T1 and T2 and P1, we can find P2. Similarly, sometimes at a temperature T1, volume is V1 in case of the gas which obeys additional law. A gas is the additional law obey chestundo, a gas at temperature T1 and volume V1 and T2 and volume, what is the volume V2? They may ask. In such case, pressure should not be there. That's why here P is proportional to, we can write T by V. Now instead of P, you substitute T by V. Then you simplify them. Then you will get some relation between T and V. Okay, in such a way we have to do. So this is the additional law process. Okay, if additional law is given, how to find the different thermodynamic coordinates means by the in this way we have to find. Okay, with this expansion of gases topic was completed. Okay.